You may be seated. Hallelujah. I count it a privilege again to be privileged to bring a word of blessing. I appreciate God for that. And I appreciate our Father and the Lord for the privilege. Praise the name of the Lord. Yesterday I was talking on the subject of greatness by what? Everybody have forgotten? Supposing we are to write exam. Who can remind me the subject of yesterday? Greatest by covenant. Hallelujah. Please turn your Bible to Deuteronomy chapter 2. I'm taking the subject tonight, fighting for the next level. Fighting for the next level. Try not to forget. Fighting for the next level. And I'm reading Deuteronomy chapter 2. I read from verse 1 to verse number 3. Deuteronomy chapter 2, verse 1. Then we turned and took our journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. And the Lord spake unto me, and we compassed Mount Seir many days. And the Lord spoke unto me, saying, you have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn you not what? Let's read verse 3 together. It's like many of us are not there. Let's read now, verse 3. You have compared this mountain long enough. Turn you not what? And I asked myself, how long have they compassed the mountain? How long? And if you go back to verse 1, then we turned and took our journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea, and the Lord speak unto me, and we compound with Seir what? Many days. How long? Many days. They compound the mountain for many days. But the Lord said to them, you have compound this mountain long enough. So to God, many days was too long. Talk less of many years. I want to believe that you will be provoked tonight to fight for the next level. No one changes level without a fight. No one. If you don't fight, you remain the way you are. No one changes level without a fight. You keep fighting until you get to the level of greatness. No one changes level without a fight. If you take it easy, life will ease you out. You can't take it easy and get to the top. You can't take it easy and fulfill destiny. Changing of level demand what? A fight. Somebody say a fight. I'm not hearing your voice. Again, a fight. At times you are fighting discouragement. At times you are fighting principalities and power. At times you are fighting fellow human beings who want to be stumbling block on your way. No one changes level without a fight. You refuse to fight, you remain the way you are. You refuse to fight, all that who came after you will overtake you. You refuse to fight, then you become a subject of pity and ridicule. No one changes level without a fight. Tell yourself, I am going to fight for a change of level tonight. As a child of God, for all of us here, God expects us to be changing level upwardly from time to time. What does God expect of what? To be changing level upwardly. Somebody say upwardly. Tell it upwardly. Someone that is going down the line, it changing level. But that's not the kind of level we are talking about. Someone that is going down the line, what is it? It's changing level. But that's not the kind of changing level that God expects for you and I. The kind of level that God wants you and I to change is changing level upwardly. Upwardly. A tenant becoming a landlord. That's what I'm talking about. An employee becoming an employer. That's what I'm talking about. Somebody who has not before begin to have and begin to give up. That's what I'm talking about. Changing level upwardly. I bless somebody here tonight. You never go down again. I say you will never go down again. Can I hear your voice? You never go down again. The louder you're aiming, the better. You will never go down again. Be on your feet and say to yourself, I will never go down again. Come and say it one more time. Let me hear your voice. Can I hear the louder the better? I will never go down again. Two more times. Let me hear your voice. I will never go down. Come and say it one more time. I will never go down. The Lord will confirm it for you. I said the Lord will confirm it for you. I bless somebody in the name of the Lord. You never go down again. Financially, you will never go down again. Ministerially, you never go down again. Professionally, you never go down again. Materially, you never go down again. Socially, you never go down again. Spiritually, you never go down again. Can I hear your loud dimension and agreement? Take us in. So for every child of God, what God desire of you and I, it will be changing level what? Upwardly. Someone say upwardly. Some are changing level, but they are changing level downwardly. That can't be the will of God. From having a car you don't have again, that can't be God. From being a landlord, you suddenly become a tenant. That can be God. From being an employer, you become an employee. That can be God. So some are changing level, but they are changing level downwardly. That is not God. What God desires of you and I is to be changing level upwardly. In your spiritual life, you are changing level upwardly. In your career, you are changing level. In your business, you are changing level. In every area of your life, you are changing level. Listen to me. There's nothing that commands respect more than progress. What did I say? There's nothing that commands respect more than progress. Your result will naturally compare your enemy to honor you. In Africa, age does not command respect. Or Methuselah will have been the most respected man. The only achievement Methuselah had is that he was the oldest man. But what does he achieve? Nothing. You can't be making progress and not command respect. When your result become undeniable, even people that don't want to respect you will be compelled to respect you. There are places you enter by virtue of your result. Even though there's no seat anywhere for you to sit, somebody will stand up for you to sit. I bless you in the name of the Lord. I came with an anointing for prophecy tonight. Among your colleagues, you will not lag behind. I say, among your colleagues, you will not lag behind. I say, among your colleagues, you will not lag behind. I decree, where great men get to, you will get here. Whatever is slowing down the journey of your destiny, I break it in the name of Jesus. Can I hear your loud dimension and agreement? From the account of Deuteronomy chapter 2 and verse 2 to 3, the Lord said to Moses, he said, you have compared this mountain for too long. And what amazed me, they have only compared the mountain for some days. But to God, it was too long. Many of you have been at your present condition for too long. You have been the way you are for too long. There are people here, you have overstayed at your present condition. You have been there for too long. And that something to provoke you for a change. Is somebody hearing that? You must get to a point where you become angry. Spiritually, you have been like this for too long. Financially, you have been like this for too long. Socially, you have been like this for too long. And hear me again. If you don't fight for a change of level, you never experience one. Someone said to me, say, sir, I've not been cheerful for the past 3 months. and nobody visited me. Nobody followed me up. And I said to her, I thought you have left that level. How can you be in Christ for 15 years and you still need to be followed up? You should leave that level. Something happened and then that became, you have to go and leave from the church for 3 months. Come and little and tell your neighbor, leave that level. Shake him, let him know you are talking to him. Leave that level. I saw one man in John chapter 5, verse 5 to 6. John chapter 5 and verse 5 to 6. The man was at one level for 38 years. How many years? 38 years. 38 years. He did not change his condition. 38 years. He did not change location. Everything about him was the same for 38 years. Until Jesus came there. And even when Jesus came and was talking to him, will you like to change level? He said, I have no man. You are not supposed to stay too long at one level. So tonight you will be provoked to pray. But before we go to pray, I want to tell you the reason why some people remain at the same level for a long time. Reasons why some people remain at the same level for a long time. 4 years after, the story the same. 10 years after, the story the same. 5 years again, 7 years again, the story the same. Reasons why some people remain at the same level for a long time. Number one, because of iniquity. There is nothing that brings stagnation like sin. Sin is a sinker. It can sink anyone's destiny. Proverbs 14:34. Righteousness exalts a nation. And if righteousness exalts, there's no doubt unrighteousness will demote. You can't be living in sin and expect condition to be changing for better. Because God is the only one that changes condition for people. And the same God you are displeasing will not be bothered about changing your condition. Listen to me. If you want your level to change, you must make up your mind by a choice. Somebody say by a choice. Tell again, by a choice. You must make up your mind by a choice that I will live a life that is pleasing to God. Righteousness exalts, sin demotes. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 18. The path of the just like a shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 18. The path of the just like a shining light. Who is a just man? Someone that walk in the fear of the Lord. A just man is not someone that refuse to smile. A just man is not someone that refuse to associate with other people. A judge like someone that fear the Lord. Someone that will do anything to please God. Listen to me. You can't please God and please men at the same time. Because what pleases men won't please God. And what pleases God won't please men. So one fundamental factor that will command a change is that you are living a life that is pleasing to God. Somebody said to me, sister, I am always being tempted. I said, that is not a sin. Yielding to the temptation is a sin. There is no mortal man who does not get tempted. No mortal man. Do you agree with that? Even Jesus was tempted. The Bible says every temptation you go through, Jesus went through the same. But you can be tempted and refuse to sin. That you are no more tempted don't already mean you are God. It's not an excuse. Songs of Solomon chapter 2 and verse 15. I saw something in this scripture. Songs of Solomon chapter 2 and verse 15. It talk about the little foxes that spoil the vine. Songs of Solomon chapter 2 and verse number 15. The little foxes that what? That spoil. He said, take all the foxes. The little foxes that spoil the vine. There are some little foxes that are hindering some people from making progress in the journey of their destiny. Come on, listen to me. There are believers whose conscience have died. what do they call it? Their conscience are dying. They are sinning and still smiling. They are doing what is wrong and nothing is condemning them anymore. Listen to me. When conscience die, redemption become impossible. Because it is conviction of your sin that leads you to repentance. Little foxes lying without feeling guilty. Little foxes. You are owing somebody money. The person there asks you to pay him his money. You became angry. Who is supposed to be angry? Little foxes. You can keep malice until Jesus comes. Bitterness of the highest order. Life never gets better as long as there is bitterness in the heart. Little foxy. You are not in talking time with your brother. You have vowed not to forgive an individual. And you want God to be involved in the course of your life. It's impossible. He said, take off the little foxy that spoiled the vine. The thing you are doing that to you is normal. I was sharing with our father in the Lord yesterday of one young guy in church whom we gave money to do some work for us in the church. Just to put tithes in front of the church. No tithes. We gave him money, that's his job. And for a long time, he was not doing the job. I fought him. I called him on phone. Why? What are you doing? When are you doing the job? And he won't do the job. And he kept coming to church. One day, because he's a member of the choir, one day I saw him in the choir, Donny Prince was saying, come and see the way he danced. Jumping and praising God, and then running on the floor and powerful praising. And after the service, asking, I said, you are still dancing? He said, yes. You know, he didn't feel what he had done is anything. He said, yes. I said, what of the money we gave you and what to do? He said, that's the reason why we not dance. He said, how much? So I don't know whether to curse him or to bless him. I just asked him to go. Listen to me. There are things you do, you call it normal. But to God, it is abnormal. You lie against an individual. And there was no way the person could say he did not do what he said he did. You lie, you talk. Somebody has been a blessing to your life and you are bastardizing his life. Somebody brought you out of the pit and you are organizing how the person will go back to the pit. Hear me and hear me. I said yesterday, everything you do today is a seed waiting for harvest tomorrow. Everything. Everything. Tell your neighbor, be careful. Everything you do today is what? It's a seed waiting. Don't just say it's a seed. End it up. It's a seed waiting for harvest tomorrow. You break somebody's heart. Get ready. A better heartbreaker will come your way. So there are things you are doing that is not allowing God to move you to the next level. Can you lift your right hand and say, Heavenly Father, every area I am struggling with sin, deliver me, O God. Set me free, O God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I made up my mind this time around. I will do it the right way, not the popular way. I will do it the right way, not the popular way. In Jesus' name. Number two reason why some people remain at the same level for a long time. Lack of a fighting spirit. Lack of a fighting spirit. Some people are just lazy, like I said yesterday. If you don't fight, you don't move. There are people who give up too easily. Anything that tamper with their pleasure and their comfort, they back out. You can't achieve anything outstanding in an easy way. I've never seen one. You can't. You can. If that dream will not cost you anything, it because it does not have a future. You must possess what? A fighting spirit. That means to say, I'm not giving up. I'm not backing out. I'm not surrendering to the devil. A fighting spirit. You are defeated, you refuse to accept defeat. You are downcast, you get up again and continue the journey. Little told me, with many people you envy today, only God know how many setbacks they have. When I came from a journey and I saw an elegant church building, I left 2 weeks before then in ruins. The natural thing to do is to quit. Is somebody hearing that? It's what? It's to quit. But my spirit became alive. I said to myself, you know, I look for so many scriptures to encourage myself, because different suggestions were coming from here and there. Somebody said quit, another person said don't continue, one said relocate, and all of that. And in all of this, I was so mindful, what is God saying? Because that is the most important. What is God saying? And when I got a clue of what God was saying, I just knew that is the beginning of our breakthrough. You must get to a point whereby you don't allow the negative thing that happened to you get into you. Don't break down. The same thing that is making you to cry happened to somebody else, and the person teaches money about. The same thing that made you to say, I won't come to church, happened to another person. Can you imagine? Somebody came to church and sat in the front and was dancing. It was serious dancing, jubilating and praising God. Even when the drama stopped, she was still dancing. And after the service, he came to my office and was dancing and said, Daddy, come and see what the Lord has done. I started dancing with her. I've not heard what God has done. And she opened her bag and brought out a letter and gave me the letter. All my assumption was that that must be a promotion letter. So I lifted the letter to her and said, Father, we thank you. Shouldn't I have opened the letter before thanking God? But I just told myself, whatever made this lady to dance like this must be something wonderful. Lo and behold, when I opened the letter, it was a letter of divorce. And I said, I asked her, well, see, after the service, you got the letter before the service. He said, Daddy, why I was dancing in the church, the letter was in my bag. You know what she said? He said, I refuse to allow my pain to tamper with my praise. But here you are. You lost a pair of shoes the following Sunday, you are not in church. Your dog became sick the following Sunday, you send a text to the pastor, I can't be in church today while my dog is going to the hospital. Everybody go through one challenge or the other. There is nothing you are going through that someone is not going through. The difference that we are more mature than each other. Stop advertising your problem on your face. No one will buy it. You come to church, you are just looking as if you are the one to answer our prayer. Not smiling, too serious. I want to say, what happened? He said, you have no heart. I lost my job. Listen to me. Whatever you see the devil doing, he could have done more if not for God. So there is still room to give thanks to God. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 10. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 10. He said, there is no temptation that has overtaken you that is not common to man. And he said something. He said, but God is faithful. But what? But God is faithful. No matter what happened to you, you must conclude that what? God is faithful. If not, that God is faithful, could have been more than that. Between losing your job and losing your life, which one do you prefer? God is faithful. If you don't have a fighting spirit, you can't move to the next level. Because things will happen that will break you down. There are people you think will support you that will work against you. There are people you think that will help you that will not help you. I ask you a question. How many family members helped Joseph to fulfill a dream? Huh? How many? Will you blame Joseph for sharing a dream with your brother? I can't blame him. What do you think Joseph was expecting when he went to a brother and shared a dream? What do you think he was expecting? I'm sure, God bless you, sir. He was expecting encouragement. He was expecting support. He was expecting a backup. Damn it, to say, my brother, don't worry. We are going to pray for you. Whatever we can do to make your dream a reality, we will do it. No family member helped Joseph to become what he became. He refused to allow what they say to enter into him. You must possess a fighting spirit. Listen to me. The thing that happened to you, God saw it before it happened. He had the power to stop it from happening. He allowed it to happen. There must be a reason behind it. There is nothing happened that take God unaware. Amos chapter 6 verse 1. Amos 6 1. Woe to them that are at ease in Zion. At ease. You want pleasure before work. Woe to them that are at ease in Zion. You want everything easy. You don't want pleasure. Woe to them. Come on, listen to me. Someone say, Lord, poison.
Morire, morire, morire bao, o se ni lore. Morire bao, morire, morire moranu bao, o se mi lore. Morire bao,
morire, morire.
I am very grateful.
Morire,
I am very grateful. Oh my God, thank you for today. For this day, thank you for your grace. O beke te beke ti yo balanu. Asiwa tu o un bobo e